Hey, I saw a couple movies. Let's talk about them.
One of the films I saw was The Kid Detective. This is the directorial debut of Evan Morgan, who co-wrote The Dirties with Matt Johnson. This film is also scored by Jay McCarroll from Nirvana the Band The Show. If you haven't seen Nirvana the Band The Show, then please check it out because it is awesome. I also made a video on it, so maybe check that one out. This film also has the same editor as Nirvana the Band The Show. Anyway, The Kid Detective stars Adam Brody, who is an adult detective who was once celebrated as a kid. Now that he's 32, he struggles to find meaning and purpose in what he does. Overall, this movie was pretty accessible, and I could imagine most people enjoying it. The story, although nothing spectacular, is enjoyable and watchable, and there are some good, genuinely funny moments here and there. There are some good performances throughout, and Adam Brody's is particularly fitting for the role. There are some nice shots here and there, but overall I think the cinematography and shot composition could use some work. There's something a little off about the way it's shot, and there are a few scenes where the framing feels a bit awkward. I will say that it did get better as it went along, and these issues became much less noticeable. Not every comedic moment works in this film, and there's nothing that I found to be absolutely hysterical. Still, overall, the comedy did work, and I'd imagine most people would be satisfied by it. There is one particular scene in this film that I found to be super tense and really memorable. And finally, the film's score was pretty great. It's probably my favorite aspect of the film, and I was really impressed by it. It's very reminiscent of noirish detective music, but also has modern elements as well. It was appropriately fitting, catchy, and interesting. Anyway, although this film didn't completely blow me away, it was really enjoyable and definitely worth the watch. And I'm giving this one a 6 out of 10. Another film I saw was Borat, Subsequent Movie Film. Now I absolutely love Borat, Bruno, Da Ali G Show, and Who is America. Sacha Baron Cohen is a fantastic character actor, and he really shines when putting people on the spot in real-life situations. The way he's able to manipulate people into revealing unflattering parts about themselves is really impressive. The humor in this film is something that I find to be hilarious. There are many hysterical moments, and it didn't take long for them to appear in the film. One of my favorite scenes was when he was pretending to be a character called Country Steve. He sang a song at a Republican rally with the expectation that the audience would be singing along with him, and the shit that he's able to get the audience to say is pretty hilarious. It's very reminiscent of the rodeo scene in the original Borat, where he got people to cheer for very questionable statements. Now, both of the Borat films use satire to criticize aspects of American culture, but the biggest difference between these two films is that the first is more general, while the sequel seems to be hyper-focused on American politicians and the upcoming election. I would also argue that the overall experience of the first film is much more memorable and impactful. Watching the sequel made me want to rewatch the original, so I did, and the difference in energy between these two films is pretty apparent. The first film is so much more jam-packed and insane. Rewatching the film makes it pretty obvious why it was so massively successful in the first place. My personal favorite film of his would be Bruno, and I actually made a video quite a while ago with my thoughts on both Borat and Bruno. Anyway, my biggest issue with this new film is that I feel as though the satirical elements aren't nearly as strong. It almost feels a little dumbed down in terms of how the messages are portrayed in this film. At the end of the film, there's a scene where the characters are explicitly supporting the same morals and ideals as the filmmakers, and it's a recreation of a scene where in the original it was the exact opposite. Like, the original film is obviously not anti-Semitic, hence the actual satire, so to recreate that scene for this film while completely removing the satirical elements not only makes the film worse, but it also feels like a complete betrayal of the character. The way it's presented, it doesn't really feel like it stayed true to the original film. Regardless, it's not a gigantic issue, and it only takes place at the end. Overall, this film was absolutely hilarious, and although it's not nearly as great as the original, it is still really fun to watch. And I'm giving this one a 7 out of 10.
Why do I look so weird? I probably should cast light.
Damn it!